In this lesson, we're going to look at how to use Memcache in App Engine applications. One good thing about using Objectify is that you can configure it to automatically use Memcache to cache your entity data. All you have to do is add @cacheAnnotation to your entity class. Then Objectify is going to do its best to use Memcache whenever possible when you try to get entity data to reduce hits to the data store. It's really easy to use Objectify with Memcache, but there's a few things that you should know about how Objectify uses Memcache. For one thing, it only uses Memcache when you get an entity by key, you save it, or you delete it. And query results are not cached. Objectify puts the property values into Memcache. It doesn't put the entire entity into Memcache. Another thing that it's really helpful to be aware of is that Objectify has its own session cache. So often when you do a get by key, Objectify is going to get the results from the session cache without even going to Memcache, let alone going to the data store. So here's what the profile class looks like with the @cacheAnnotation. All I did was add @cache to the entity class definition. And now Objectify is going to use Memcache to cache property values whenever possible. I don't even have to write a single line of code to do it. So when your application's been deployed to AppSpot, you can use the Memcache Viewer to view the Memcache entries. I'm going to flush Memcache to make sure that I have no Memcache entries to start with. So now I have no entries in Memcache. I'm going to go and do some things in my application to see if I can get some Memcache entries. When you go to the profile page, it gets your profile entity out of the data store if you already have a profile. That's how it knows what your display name and t-shirt size are. Here in the profile page, I'm going to make a change my t-shirt size, and update my profile. I'm also going to go to the Show Conferences page and show all the conferences. The list of conferences is retrieved as a query, and as I already mentioned, Objectify doesn't use Memcache for query results. However, we do actually get the profile entity by key, so we can figure out the display name of the organizer. I can also drill down into conference details, which does a get by key. So now I've done a few things that involve getting entities by key from the data store. Let's see if any of the results got cached in Memcache. So you need to be sure to refresh the Memcache viewer to get the latest data. And here you see there are some Memcache entries. I've actually only got one item, and I thought maybe I would have had a few more than that. The reason there might not be as many items in Memcache as you expect is because Objectify has its own session cache, so it's going to save data in the session cache, which will reduce use not only of Memcache, but of the data store. So anyway, you end up seeing less items that you might in the Memcache viewer because of the session cache. So go ahead and update the conference and profile entity classes to use Memcache. It's a good practice to always check any changes to your app on localhost first, so feel free to do that. And you're going to need to deploy to AppSpot because we want to use the Memcache viewer, and for that your app has to be running on AppSpot. After you've deployed your app to AppSpot, go to the Memcache viewer, and if you have any items in Memcache, you might or you might not, but if you do, go ahead and flush Memcache. Then in your application, go ahead and do some things to put some data into Memcache, so create some conferences, show conferences, view details, maybe create or change a profile, and then go back to the Memcache viewer and see if you've got any entries in Memcache. You might need to do a few things in your application to get some entries to show up, and you'll probably see less items in the Memcache viewer than you might expect because Objectify uses its own session cache.